as well, which is that there is that lag time. And if China gets the head start, does that mean it's in a better position? But I think, you know, when it comes to economic activity, you really do need more than just one actor. So even if China goes around trying to finance infrastructure projects and so forth, if the local government doesn't have the capacity to shoulder such a project, then that also adds a limitation, a very real limitation on China's ability to engage in such economic activity. So even if China does have a head start, I think if anything, that's probably a positive thing for the rest of the world at this stage, that there is at least one major economic power that's not completely straddled constrained by COVID-19 and its effects. But having said that, it can possibly create greater relationships of asymmetry. And I think one of the concerns that people are seeing is that, you know, China, despite COVID-19, despite mass diplomacy, hasn't given up on some of its traditional priorities. So it's still acting assertively in the South China Sea, over the Taiwan Straits, and even in Hong Kong. So, I mean, if China's, I think that's the thing. Beijing needs to decide what kind of global posturing it wants to take, whether it's going to be assertive or whether it's going to be benign, because that will certainly have an impact on how receptive other countries are of Chinese economic activities within their countries, and in kind of bolstering or lessening those trading relationships with China.